Well, Opie, we'll talk about your ride in the last race. First of all, runner number six, and that being Show the World. Certainly a runner that showed a fair bit of potential as a three-year-old last year.
Yeah, he was a really nice three-year-old. He was still a little bit weak back then. He went to Australia and he was just a little bit below them. So he's come back this time and he's trialled up okay, but he's fresh up over a mile, so he still might need the run today.
Okay, then, of course, looking forward to tomorrow, and then that'll be it for you, Opie. You've decided that you needed to just get things under control and I suppose be a bit more happier off the track with you hanging up the silks.
Yeah, I was just getting tired of taking off 2.5-3 kilos every single race meeting, so I'm not saying I'm retiring, but if I do come back, I'm going to make sure my weight's prop really well, so I don't have to take off the weight like I was doing and do it properly.
This has always been this is not a new issue. It's been an nagging issue for a number of years. But when did it really come to your mind that, you know, maybe it's time for me to stand down for a little bit?
I've been thinking about it for about a year, and probably the last 3 to 6 months, I've just haven't been riding like I know I can, and I didn't feel like I was doing the best job I could do while I was out there.
Okay. Yeah. I suppose one thing that was keeping you going was, you know, I do, obviously, with the way that she was performing and getting that Group 1 victory in the McPhee Challenge Stakes as well certainly would have helped things.
Yeah, you know, I love riding the big races. That gives me a bit of a buzz, you know, but I need to take the break to get my mind right and my body right as well and get the weight under control.
So, obviously, it's just a clean break now and then just, you know, take it as it comes, really, over the next few weeks and before you start lining up what you're thinking about doing.
That's right. I'll just I won't rush into anything and just see what happens, and something comes along, I'll definitely look at it.
I'm sure the weather will get better for some fishing and things like that soon.
Yeah, I might get the weekends free anyway.
Absolutely. Look, as we said, you've gotten a number of good winners over the years. Is there any sort of stand out for you as you sort of look back on what's happened in the first part of your career anyway?
Well, I've won 3 Couts, Princess Cope, She's Sensational, and Distinctly Secret, and they were really big wins for good people that I've ridden for right from the beginning as well. Also, Auckland Cups, I won 3 of them. They were big buzz because they were the big money back then. So, every Group 1 I've had, I've really, really enjoyed it.
Yep. No doubt it's a pretty good way to go out as well with the Hawke's Bay meeting coming up with the Group 1 race, and you know, you'd have a good chance in the event as well with Shuka.
Yeah, I really like his chances. Even there's a little bit of moisture around, it's not going to worry him. And his first 2 runs have been excellent. And he's found the line really well last time. And got a little bit of an awkward draw, but we'll overcome that.
Well, here's hoping this is not the last time we talk to you on a race day. And all the best, Opie. I know it's been a real problem for you trying to get your weight down, but you know, it'll be the best thing for you. And really thanks for your thoughts over the last few years on trackside, and go well, mate.
Yeah, cheers. Thank you.